transmute metals, perform experiments, and invent artifacts to achieve greatness in Trismegistus, the ultimate formula. Trismegistus, the Ultimate Formula, is a 1-4 player game that has dice drafting and set collection and more. It plays in about 90 to 120 minutes. It's published by Board and Dice, and they send us this copy to review. At the beginning of each round, you'll place out the experiment cards and artifacts. You'll roll all the dice and place them in the matching spots. No area can have more than 5 dice. On your player board, you'll randomly place your formula tiles and material cubes in the raw sections, the round sections. You'll also start the game with essences and the ethereal dice. The game is played over 3 rounds, and in each round, you get to draft 3 dice. You'll be using those dice to take actions to hopefully get yourself a lot of victory points to win the game. To draft your first die, you choose any one from the game board. The number of dice in that area determine the power of the die you choose. So you place the die on the number 4 if there were 4 dice in that section. Then you take exactly one action, like harvesting materials. Every point down you get one material and place it in the matching icon spot on your board. This is called spending potency. Or you could spend potency to take the matching essence. The type of essence is shown next to the matching symbol on the game board. Or you could spend potency to transmute. You may move one material to the next level, matching the color of the die for each potency spent, and you also have to spend an essence. You'll move your token up the mastery track, matching the type of essence you spent. Another action you could take is gaining an artifact, which costs exactly 3 potency, and you'll place it in one of the slots around your player board. When you transmute in the future along one of those tracks, then you'll take the bonus of that tile and flip that artifact face down. You can also, as an action, spend a potency to recharge an artifact. Or as an action, you could spend one potency to take one experiment card matching the symbol of your die. When it's not your turn, you actually have the ability to do a reaction by spending a reaction token, and that's basically taking a regular action, like gaining material, gaining essences, transmuting, and recharging. But it's based on the opponent's die color or the symbol on that die. There are free actions that you can take on your turn, like purchasing a formula. The cost increases the more formulas you buy. Place a tile into your vault. You could spend a formula for free, like gaining gold, silver, tokens, and more. Or perform an experiment. You must meet the mastery track requirement, pay the cost, and then you'll receive the bonuses listed. Slide the card under the matching spot on your game board. If it's the first one, then you'll also receive a formula tile. When you complete a row or column in your vault, you'll also get some cool bonuses, like getting a reaction token, advancing the mastery tracks, getting more ethereal dice, or even getting a gold. You also have other kinds of tokens in the game, like these that let you immediately increase the potency of the die you just drafted, or these chameleon that let you change the color and symbol. You don't change out your die, you just state what it is and do the action. After you use all the potency of your die, then on your next turn, you'll draft a new die. And that round will be over when all players have drafted and used their 3 dice. And then after 3 rounds, the game is over and you'll count up points. Points from completed experiments, completed publications, completed formulas, gold, and ethereal dice tokens are a point each. And then points based on where you are on the mastery tracks. This is a very, very thinky game. The actions that you take and when you take them will have a rippling effect of what you can do later in the game. And that die color and symbol will make a big deal on what you can or can't do on your turn. You may want to transmute along the red line, but you have a black die, so you'll have to wait to do that later or spend a reaction token if someone else is using a red die. So you do have to be aware of what other players have, not necessarily everything that they're doing. It'll just help you react well knowing what dice they're using on a given turn. There's just a lot going on in the game. For instance, I wish there was an easier way to relay to the raw materials to their matching essences. There's just a lot of iconography going on. The nice thing is that the back of the rulebook has a legend for you to look at if you have any questions on what symbols mean. Near the back of the rulebook, there is a whole page of easily forgotten rules. For instance, this one says, silver can be used to pay for temporary mastery increases for the purpose of performing experiments. You're not going to move your markers or anything like that. It's just going to help you complete those experiment cards a lot faster. Or gold is a wild resource for all purposes. So these are very helpful for you to reference throughout the game. I like the player boards and how they are double layered to fit the formulas and have slots for the artifacts. I don't like the color choices at the top. I think they're actually very confusing. You're supposed to match your completed experiments to these spots, and the blue and green make sense, but the red is a different shade and black matching yellow? Not sure what happened there. Maybe the card and border could both be yellow or a darker gray. There's going to be a lot of ways for you to advance in the game through the bonuses that you get. For instance, on the back of the rulebook, it shows, like down here, there's a lot of different icons that show you how you can advance up the mastery track, which is pretty important in the game. Or down here, you can actually transmute on different colors, but you'll still have to pay the essence cost. I personally like the board art, and I think it fits the theme well. And the card art's cool with the different experiments. Now, Trismegistus is definitely replayable with all the different paths that you can take in the game. And I would say there's also some variability in the game too with the player's laboratories. The theme really comes through for me in the transmuting of the different metals to try and get gold. Now, Teotihuacan is another game from Board and Dice that uses dice in a unique way. And one of the designers of Trismegistus is actually the designer of Teotihuacan. Now, I would say Trismegistus is a much more difficult game. And I like both of those games, and I can't choose a favorite yet. They do both deserve a spot on my game shelf. So if you're looking for a very, very thinky game, you like the unique ways of using dice in a game, this is so interesting with just how simple it is. You're just drafting a die, but how important it is on what die you actually draft. If this sounds interesting to you, then definitely check out Trismegistus from Board and Dice. We'll be releasing at Essen and then soon after in retail. Thank you for watching this video. We'll have more videos coming soon, and we would love for you to subscribe to Tantrum House.